As a developer, you need to know and use Appian's out-of-the-box or built-in accessibility features and avoid forging ahead with your own alternative designs that may create barriers for people with disabilities. After completing this lesson, you should be able to locate Appian's accessibility documentation, use accessible headers and layout labels in UI design, and configure form input fields to provide context and meaning to users. When you're in the UX design phase and trying to incorporate accessibility requirements into your plans, you'll need to know the numerous built-in features that Appian provides to help you make your interfaces accessible. Appian documentation provides guidance on building accessible applications. We suggest you read these pages first so you can take advantage of Appian's built-in accessibility features. You should revisit these pages on a regular basis as Appian releases new features and updated guidance throughout the year. While this lesson focuses on major features, there are many others that can help make an application accessible, such as visible focus and hover behavior. Be sure to check the documentation on Appian's recommendations for different browser and screen reader combinations. Check back regularly as we keep these up to date. Now, let's look at some interface components that must be configured properly in order for users with disabilities to fully engage with an application. We'll begin with headers, which are normally used to separate sections on a page. Did you know that screen readers use headers as the primary method for navigating and locating content on a page? While sighted users may be able to quickly scan a page by looking for headers, people with visual impairments rely on hearing a screen reader identify header tags. Appian recommends using standard interface components to leverage their accessibility features. Use section labels, form layout labels, and box layout labels. These labels provide specific information to help screen reader users understand page structure and content. If you're using rich text instead, be sure to use a rich text header. Don't use rich text items to mimic the appearance of a header. If you go ahead and create headings by using rich text items, the screen reader will need to read this text. Would it be clear to you that this is a heading? A better design choice would be to use a rich text header because the screen reader user would hear the word header and know what to expect. With regard to section headings used in a layout, be sure to use accessibility heading tags to identify the different levels for screen readers. Using correct heading levels provides structure so that all users can better understand your content. Many applications provide forms for end users to fill out. Let's say Calvin designed this form for end users to fill out when they need to open a support case. Calvin did the minimal requirement to make the form accessible, which is to use labels to configure the input fields. After a test run, John, who was blind, provided feedback on his experience in using the form. Unlike sighted users, John can't see all the fields at once. Screen reader users navigate forms one element at a time. So when John heard the field name, but no other information, he entered only his first name. However, as he advanced to the next field, he realized that he should have entered both his first and last names, so he had to go back and refill that field. Same problem for the location field. Calvin did not know that screen reader users navigate forms one element at a time. When a user navigates to an input field, the screen reader first reads any available information about the input field to help provide context on what the user should enter. Calvin should have provided additional information to users by adding instructions, tooltips, and/or accessibility text. He now understands that unless these are set explicitly on a field, users will not have sufficient guidance in entering the appropriate data. Designing accessible interfaces doesn't mean you have to give up layout aesthetics. While it's recommended that you use labels explicitly on form inputs, you can use hidden labels elsewhere if visible ones are not desired. Screen readers can read field labels that are hidden or collapsed. A final design tip is to use the input purpose parameter on a text field to help users enter data faster. select a purpose from the drop-down list. This parameter enables auto-completion of fields by browsers and assistive technologies. All users, not only those who use screen readers, can benefit from having the input purpose enabled. In this lesson, you learned where to locate Appian's accessibility documentation. You learned that Appian provides many out-of-the-box or built-in accessibility features that should be used instead of your own customized designs that may create barriers for people with disabilities. You learned to use accessible headers and layout labels in UI design and to configure form input fields to provide context and meaning to users.